Alright, greetings fellow Oathlings, welcome back. This is the same video actually for me, for same recording session for me, but a different video for you. This video will be about the general gameplay mechanics of the Elder Scrolls Arena, specifically how cities and, you know, minor dungeons and stuff, side quests work, and yeah. No other holiday divides the people of Graddun Spring like the third of Hearthfire. A few of the oldest, most superstitious men and women do not speak all day long for the fear that the evil spirits of the dead will enter their bodies. Most citizens enjoy the holiday, calling it Tales and Tallows, but even the most light-hearted avoid the dark streets of Graddun Spring, for everyone knows the dead do walk tonight. I think they walk every night, to be honest. I mean, I've been attacked by them. Anyway, we'll get to that later. Only the Mages Guild complete the tribes on this day. In celebration of the oldest magical science, necromancy, all magical items are half price today. Good time for me to go check out the Mages Guild. Anyway, so I think I am in Graddun Spring right now, and here is a very helpful fellow coming over to help me. And where is the Mages Guild? So first off, first things first, as a spellcaster, the Mages Guild is... did he say south? I think he did. East. Okay, fine. So yeah, as a spellcaster, the Mages Guild is your best friend, needless to say. Because you can basically create spells. Now when I say create spells, I don't mean actually create spells. You can modify existing spells to suit your own to suit you basically. And let me just go ahead and save here, because I just remembered that I haven't saved. So you can basically roam around and you can click on people to ask them about them. It doesn't really matter. You can ask them where the location of, you know, the nearest thing is, the nearest in temple or store. We'll get to those later. And you can ask them about the main quest objectives as well. The temple, right now I want to look for the Mage Guild, so I will ask them about the Mage Guild. Oh, you'll find that east of here. On top of the screen is your compass, which you can make disappear with the F8 key and reappear with the same key. And yeah, so you click on buildings, specifically the doors, to identify them. You can press the M button to open your map and it will be identified on your map as well. Structures like these are usually Mages Guilds. I guess this is a better guided tour now that, you know, I have the benefit of already having played this game once. You enter a rare equipment store from the sunny autumn day. Cases of weaponry are featured next to some of the more peaceful supplies and gears. The only reason I'm here as a mage is to sell all the things that I won't be able to use and get money in the process, like plate gauntlets. Oh boy. Okay, how about 37? 37? Sure, you're not gonna come up to 36 anyway, so... Plate helm. 8... Ooh, that's actually quite nice. How about 1300 for that? So basically, this is called haggling. You can haggle with the, you know, Mages Guild and the bartenders at the inns, and well, basically these guys, these blacksmiths at weapon stores. Whenever you sell them or buy things from them, so for example, this plate helm is worth 135 gold. Now, how much you can haggle entirely depends upon your stats, basically your willpower, your personality, your intelligence, and a little bit of it on your luck. So willpower, intelligence, and personality basically determine how much money you'll be getting every time that you do decide to haggle, like how much you can haggle for. So the higher those stats are, the more you can haggle for, and it also depends upon the price of the item, of course. And yeah, so that's how it works. I cannot use the short sword either. Okay, 3 gold, I'm not even gonna haggle for that. So no, I don't want to repair anything, I want to sell the iron longsword. That's pretty much... Ooh, that is an enchanted longsword. And I think I should hold on to it till I get it to... Ah yes, but I can't equip it like anyway, so it doesn't really matter for me. So as a mage, you can't equip longswords and stuff. but you can haggle for them. So all you need to do is just hit the counter button if you don't like the price, and give them a price which is close to their price, but more to your liking. So for example, I'll try 4,000. They accepted it. I don't think so, but I'll take. But if you'll take 3,880 gold instead, you've got a deal. So what you can do is, once you're sure that a number is like the higher limit or near that limit, you can just keep spamming it until they, you know, cave in and come closer to whatever it is that you're offering. And once their bartering is becomes, you know, like once they start getting rigid in their bartering, they'll increase the value by 2 gold, 4 gold, 1 gold even. So yeah, that's the time to know that you should stop bargaining and you should accept their offer just like this. If you talk me into it, I guess. Here's a gold. Can I have the longsword now? Sure, I'm not gonna use it anyway. But yeah. 58.50, my god, did I get good loot or what? Holy hell, man. I mean, I didn't get this good loot as a fucking warrior my last playthrough. Especially not this early on in the game. Anyway, so as I was saying, there's a limit to how many times you can haggle. If you haggle too many times, then then they're gonna get upset with you and they're not gonna, you know, buy that stuff from you anymore. I mean, you can sell it to them again and you'll have to go through the whole haggling process again. So I like to haggle between 4 to 5 times, 6 times at the most. I like to keep a spare for in case I make mistakes, but yeah, I think the hard limit is like 7 or 8 times. You can't haggle more than that. But the war axe, yeah, fine. I doubt I would need them anymore. So dagger, buckler, and I didn't even have a staff. And also go into the shop and click on this guy and repair any of your inventory items, except for potions, of course. You can't repair potions. So you can also repair magical items. Anything that you have, you can repair them, unless they come under the category of items which give you passive effects. Let's buy some armor from this guy. Just a buckler, that's it, that's all this guy has. Or am I just not allowed to wear any armor? Damn, I'll have to look that up. A staff. At least this guy has a staff. So yeah, I can... Coritar Elsinore is my name. I'll sell you a staff for only 5 gold. How about 3? Forget it. Look, pal, I know what it's worth. You come up with a serious offer or I'll sell to someone else. Then you'll just have to hope you don't meet them in combat. Man, these guys don't make it easy. Fine, you just bought yourself a staff. You were selling it for 5 fucking gold. You can sell it for 1 gold less. Don't be so fucking good. Come on. Anyway, yeah. So you can basically repair your items as well. As a knight, you have the advantage of not having to repair anything because you're a knight. So yeah, I mean, that's just one of the things that you get as an advantage. Buildings like these, usually colossally sized buildings, these are the mage's guilds. And this is the best place for, well, practically everybody, but a little more special. These places are a little more special for people like us, people like mages. You can actually edit your spellbook here. Behind you fall the sunshed. Behind you the fall sun sheds warmth upon the land, holding back the icy fingers of winter yet another day. It's autumn, I take it. Around you are arcane implements and mystical apparatus. You feel a strange tingling on your skin. Or wait, is autumn for Westerners? Does it come later? I guess it does. Let's see. So this guy who's shaking his head is the... Well, he's one of the mages in the Mages Guild and he will be selling his stuff. Now, what we can do here is, you won't get this option as a non-magic user. You can always steal from people, but... Or in case you're in an inn, you can sneak into a room. If you fail once, they might let you slide. If you fail again, they will call on the guards, who are brutal, brutal fucks. Trust me on that. They will rip you apart, head to toe. No consideration whatsoever for anything else. So, yeah. At least on low levels. I mean, once you reach like level 20, 21, they're one of the easier enemies of the game. So, yeah, knights. Anyway, let's detect the magic on these braces first. Okay. I thought detection was free today. Fine. So yeah, once you detect the magic, it costs you. If whatever. Oh, these are the braces of sanctuary. That is an amazing steal, to be honest. So yeah. That was a dwarven bolt. That was whatever talk that is. Okay, adamantium talk. Anyway, so. So once you detect, once you get your stuff detected, you can just hit F1 key or click on your own picture to open the inventory, and you'll notice that there is. Oh wait, a staff is a two-handed weapon. I would rather prefer the buckler then. For some reason, I thought that it was perhaps a. I don't know. Anyway, and with the current amount of spell points that I have, I can't even cast half of the stuff. Anyway, so. Yeah, I still have 11,000 gold, so I think I can get something worthwhile done for myself here. So yeah, once you detect them, they'll be identified. Oh yeah, that's what I wanted to show you, I forgot. So they'll be identified in your inventory like yay. Dwarven bolts, adamantium talk, braces of sanctuary. You can also like, I mean, unless it's an item which you can use magically, so to speak, you can't exactly see it in your inventory. Yeah. The U button, or where is it? I think it was this button. Yeah, that's basically your what do you call it? Your inventory. Right click to exit. This button, or the C button, C key, is your what do you call this? Your spellbook. You don't have this as a non-magic class, needless to say. If you click on this, you draw your sword. Right clicking on this does the same. Pilfering, this is the icon for pilfering if you have a locked door or a locked chest or practically any human in front of you. I don't think humans are a target for pilfering in this game, but chests and doors are. So you can use the B key or you can use this button. This is the inventory. This, I don't know why it looks so much like grabbing a sword, like half-swording. This is the rest button. You can use the R key as well. This is the status. And as you can see, I'm carrying only 5 kgs after having sold all of those things, and I'm healthy. I can use the S key to do the same thing as well, but as you can see, the position is slightly lower. This is the map. You click on it, it's going to open the local map for you and show you the layout of the place. You right click on it. I can't travel from here, but I'll show you in a while. So first off, let's just go ahead and how about I show you towards later of the game when we are, you know, headed to Fangler. I already know where it is, but we will try to ascertain the location by asking around. Yeah. Yeah, so basically, let's see. We can buy some spells here. We can purchase Levitate, and yeah, we can purchase Levitate. Caster can float for 5 rounds plus 1 round per 1 level. Yeah, this makes sense. That Levitate is one of my favorites. Very practical indeed. I'll be happy to sell it to you for a mere 50 gold. Now you can haggle with them as well. So there is nothing... I mean, actually the mages are easier to haggle with than like the blacksmiths. Moving on. We can also purchase potions of... restore power right here. Like, for example, the prices have been lowered quite significantly. How about we start off with 99 of them? 3663 gold, we could come down to 2800, I think. Amazing, I lucked out again. Huh. And we could also purchase some magic items here. For example, the Mark of Visits Fire, Mark of Stamina, Mark of Wanderlight, and the Ebony Bracelet. Ebony bracelet would be really good, but I don't really have the gold for it. I'll consider selling it for 725 gold. How about we come down to 650? Bartering is such a huge part of the game that it is like essential for you to barter everywhere, like literally everywhere. And yeah, 650. How about 575? This guy looks like somebody who just gave up, you know, he eventually just stopped bartering altogether. And I don't really know what to make of that. I sort of feel like a monster now. But anyway, moving on. You walk up to someone. They should usually stop for you, like this one does here. And I will ask them about the nearest temple. And we will... Whoops. Where is the nearest temple? It seems to be that there is only one temple here. A bit southeast, the direction we were facing. So let's go then. Now, the thing about temples is that they are... This looks like a dungeon. This is probably a dungeon. Now, this thing here is called a prostitute. And I think I would have been here. So right-clicking on the map will open up this entire menu. I'm in the Summerset Isles, not High Rock. How ironic. I'm home. I was wondering why all of this looks so familiar, why they look yellow, like Altmers, because they are Altmers. Wow, anyway, so yeah, right-clicking on the map gets you here. I think shift, pressing shift-M also does the same thing, or control-M, I don't really know. You can click on the province, and you can just select any city you want to go to and travel there without any problems. And, yeah. So these people here, if you ask them any questions, especially like, I meet more high elf boys than girls, but business is business. I'm Simbase Fona Silly Norin. Okay, so yeah, this person is a prostitute. You can ask them about a lot of things. If you ask them about things such as these, they generally don't have an answer for them. But people like this can usually give you the correct answer for the main objectives. Have you tried asking at a temple? They seem to know everything. Well, right now, for example, this woman doesn't know about... No one's heard of that in the past 500 years. She doesn't know about where to go looking for Fanglier. But, yeah, if people like these, they usually do know where... Have you tried asking at the temple? They seem to know everything. So, yeah, people like these, they usually do know about Fanglier and... Not just Fanglier, I mean the main questline objectives. There should be one here, or here, yeah, right here, the Snake Charmer. These are all characters of interest, and I do not believe we had met High Elf. I am Solinar Gaorin, and this is Demisina, my snake. Okay, where is Fanglier? Have you tried near Hammerfell? I heard something strange happened thereabouts. So these people usually do have answers. In the event that, and this is another prostitute, another skin for the prostitute, so in the event that other people do not know, making boys happy, ain't that nice? Yeah, I think my character wants to be like you, not really, but Fanglier, sorry friend, I thought that was just a myth. Just go around and ask people like these and they will point you towards the correct place to be. If they tell you about a place, chances are that that is where, you know, the next, objective lies. So for example, they mention Hammerfell here. Now you need to go to Hammerfell and ask around until they'll tell you the name of the city. You go to the city and ask around there and they'll tell you exactly where to go, which is usually a palace or something like a temple or a mage's guild or... usually along those lines. So you wouldn't be the first searching for that. Why don't you try somewhere in the cities of Hammerfell? I heard something happened there. Cool. And I am an idiot. Ah, I completely missed this. The saddest part is I have already visited this temple and the city once before. The Conclave of Charity. Now, the thing about temples is that you can actually visit the priest and you can get yourself cured here. You can also get yourself, you don't have any diseases, they can't cure you, of course. You can also get yourself healed here, if you don't have any means to heal yourself. And because you can't exactly rest out on the roads inside the city. And you can ask them to bless you, which is a very bad idea. Because normally what the developers intended was, once the priest blesses you, it basically acts like an agility boost. It makes it easier for you to hit your enemies. And yeah, it basically makes it easier for you to hit your enemies for a certain amount of time. But unfortunately, how it plays out is, once you actually hit somebody, like once you get blessed, the enemies can also hit you much easier. So yeah, it's sort of a double-edged sword. It makes life a lot more difficult for you, so it's best not to get blessed, even though you might have the chance to do so. I'm in sort of a surplus of cash right now, so... Yeah, so... The Spellmaker. This is basically how you make spells. Yeah, I did that. And what can we create here? Nah. Effects cause continuous damage. Health. Fine. And increase by 5 per level. Strikes. Yeah, that works. And one target. Touch. One target at range, area centered on caster, area at range, explosion. Yeah, I want one target at range, or perhaps an even area at range. A little expensive to be honest. Nah. Let's go one target at range. That should be a little more. Let's call it the Shredder. And yeah, that's basically how this system works. Has been inscribed into my spellbook, and I've officially blown away all of my money. Now, however, if I open the spell menu here, I can basically see all the spells that I have. Ultra Heal, Shredder, and Cure Disease, which I created. Very expensive spells which I cannot cast at this point, but I have them anyway, so what the hell. Right? I guess that we have covered almost everything about there is to the cities, like about the cities, but yeah, you can get outside of the gates, you can just practically roam around in the wilderness, you'll find monsters in the forests, and you'll also find like random dungeons here and there. You'll also find dungeons inside the cities. You can loot them, you can hit them up for loot. You enter the Howling Galley, heartened by the smells of food and spices, and prepare to relax in the warm sunlight. Okay, so, oh yeah, I completely forgot how to mention this part. These people here are the rudest people you'll meet anywhere. So look at Tall John here. Don't bother with a cheap room at the Howling Galley, High Elf. Get at least a double. Well, this guy was actually helpful. Begone, oh High Elf. I don't wish to converse with you. Not too rude. Who are you, decent Tune, High Elf? I call that Graddun Spring, Jewel of Summerset. Interesting. Oh yeah, I completely forgot about that as well. So those are bards. You can also ask them about the location of places and stuff. I don't mean to be rude to you, but go away. I think they're not being as rude simply because of the fact that I've got like a higher... They are being pretty polite actually. In my Nord Warrior build, I didn't really have that much intelligence or personality because I didn't need that as a warrior. And these guys are very rude to me. Very rude. But I guess, yeah, this works, I suppose. So yeah, before you reach the bar, a singularly well-known person called Mother Saruril signals you and speaks in a conspirational whisper. I need help, young High Elf. So this is basically one of the ways you can get tasks. You just randomly walk into a bar and somebody had a task waiting for you. Of course, you can agree to them or disagree. And the higher your level gets, the more gold you will be given. So yeah. I need help, young elf. I'm supposed to get a Tome of Philosophy back from an agent of mine in the Mage's Guild. If I don't have it by Freda's Fourth of Earthfire, I will lose a good deal of money. Unfortunately, I cannot get the Tome of Philosophy myself. I'll give you 45 gold if you get me the Tome of Philosophy on time. Do you agree? Yes, sure. You are my savior, good high elf. Goodbye and good luck. Okay, so you can buy drinks here. I'll just go for gin and tonic. And you can sneak into a room. You can get a room. Singles are cheap. doubles are more expensive. Suites, king suites, and emperor suites are much more expensive. You can ask them for rumors as well. General rumors. Well, nothing much is going on, near as I can tell you. And about work, ask around on the street. Lots of folk have a better idea than I. Sometimes they would have good ideas about work. Sometimes, and most, sometimes they won't. So it basically depends upon the bartender you talk to. Yeah, so one of the things you can do is just ask random people and ask them about work as well. Don't know if this will interest you, but it's got income potential. Just north of here is the Silver Dagger. Look for a slightly impatient man called Mad Morna. Check out all the tough looking characters who walk in. The Silver Dagger. Okay, so basically, if you now choose to go into the Silver Dagger and talk to the bartender, you'll get work there. Where is the inn? Yeah, Inn Silver Dagger. Wow, there are a lot of inns, to the north. Of course, he just told me that. But where's the Mage's Guild, though? We do have some work over there. But yeah, these guys were really polite. My pre-recorded video would probably be there on my channel towards the end. If you want to go check out those old gameplay mechanics, you can, and those guys are pretty rude. Here's the tome of philosophy that Sarurill needs. You better be on your way back to him now. Name sounded sort of like a she, but okay. If you say it is a he, it is a he. One way to check what you need to do is click on either this button or use the L button to open your logbook. And to the Howling Galley. Okay, fine. So basically the Howling Galley. Where is the Howling Galley? Okay, so the Howling Galley. Where is the Howling Galley? And I never marked the place, so it's north of here. Fine. So yeah, this is what you do. You remember the inn where you were, and you go back to the same inn and talk to the bartender again in order to get your reward. Hey, you're there. Yeah. Where is the Howling Galley? Yeah, so this is another thing which they do. If you are super close to a certain inn or something, like a specific location, they will basically write it on your map, and all you need to do is press M and yeah, they'll identify it for you. The Silver Dagger and the Howling Galley are next to each other. How ironic is that? So yeah, you basically enter and you talk to the bartender and get a reward. I had heard you picked up the Tome of Philosophy from Mage's Guild, but I admit I feared you wouldn't get it back here on time. As promised, here are your 45 gold pieces. I'm very grateful. Thank you, noble high elf. And I guess that's it for this video. We shall meet again in the next video. Until the next video, catch you later. Thank you for watching. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.